Hello and welcome to Excel is Simple, and today let's see how we can, from this simple task list, create a dashboard which looks something like this. This dashboard has got slicers by which you can filter projects, you can filter tasks, you can filter people, or you can filter a combination of these three. Apart from that, we'll also create dashboards which are people specific, where you can select a particular person and look at their graphs. And then a project-wise dashboard where you have an overall view of all the different projects and graphs for each and every project. So let's start making these dashboards from scratch. But before that, if you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notified every time a new video is uploaded. Before starting the work on the dashboard, let's try to understand this task list. So the first column has got the project name. So if you can see, I've got 5 projects over here, project 1 to project 5. Then there is a task, which is the different types of tasks. And here each project can have any number of tasks from task type 1 to task type 10. And then I have got 5 people. So this particular column shows me which person has the task been assigned to, the start date for a task, estimated completion time in number of days. In expected closure date, we have put the function of workday, which adds the ETA to the start date while also taking into consideration the weekends. Then this is the number of days that have been reported by the person. The progress is a simple calculation of days reported divided by the ETA. Allocated budget is something that you will add at the outset. And then this column shows you what has been the actual spend till date. The next column is the percentage budget consumed, which is a simple calculation of actual spend divided by the budget and expressed as percentage. The task status, if you can see, shows 3 values: in progress, not started, or completed. And the task status takes the status from the progress column. If in progress there is 0%, it'll show as not started. If it is 100%, it's completed. And anything between 0 and 100 will be showing as in progress. So we have used a simple nested if function over here to represent this particular status. So now that you know how my task list looks like, let's start creating the dashboard. Note that the structure of the task list does not matter. You just need to see how we can create the dashboard using pivot tables. Now we know that we need to create a dashboard which looks like this. So let's create it from scratch. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to go back to this task list and right click over here, move or copy, create a copy in a new book. So now I have replicated my task list in a new Excel sheet. If you see it carefully, it is an official Excel table. Just click over here and you can see there's table 1. Official Excel tables help you a lot when you have callout data, create pivot tables, VLOOKUPs. I would always prefer to have official Excel tables whenever you're creating dashboards. So let me call it task list. Now let's insert a tab in this particular Excel sheet here. So now in order to insert the pivot table, you need to go to the insert tab in the ribbon and then click on pivot table. A new window opens up, and here you need to select the table range and the place you want to put the pivot table. So first let's select the table range. There are 2 ways to do it. You just click over here and then go to your task list like this, and then you select the entire range of content. I would say it is a bit tedious given the fact that you already created an official Microsoft Excel table. So let's just add the name of the table over here, which was task list. And then just select the cell where you want to start the table. I'll just enter this particular cell over here and press OK. So you can see the pivot table structure in my sheet. And now let's start filling the pivot table. So first thing first, what do we need? We need the project name. We'll just drag it and put it into the rows. So you can see the 5 project names coming over here. After that, we need the task, then assign to. After that, start date, expected closure date, then the ETA. Then let's say it is a days completed reported. After that, it is the progress, allocated budget, actual till date, and then the percentage budget consumed. Now we need to format this particular pivot table. So for that, what we need to do is that we need to go to design from the pivot table ribbon. From report layout, we'll select the tabular form. You can remove the months from the selection as it's not needed. In order to remove it, you just need to select it and drag it outside of the pivot table fields. Now you can see that there are various subtotals and grand totals coming in. You can just remove them as well. You can also see these smaller buttons coming in front of the values. You can remove these by going to Pivot Table Analyze and remove the buttons by clicking here. So part of our dashboard is sort of ready, but what we would also want is that the project name should come here in all of the line items, and it should not be just the first cell. So in order to repeat the project name, we'll go to Design, click on Report Layout, and then click on Repeat All Item Labels, like this. Now let's just adjust the column widths. You can change the design of your pivot table or dashboard by clicking on the Design tab and then select any particular design that you like from here. Let's say we selected this one. Okay, now let's add some conditional formatting to the progress column. In order to do that, let's select the entire column, go to conditional formatting, data bars, and let's say we want a solid fill, a green fill. Here you can see that those data ranges have been selected automatically. What you can also do is that you can go to conditional formatting, manage rules, and edit this particular rule. So instead of automatic, you can say it's a number for maximum and minimum, and the minimum is 0 and the maximum is 1, which represents 0% and 100% respectively. Click OK and OK. If you want, you can adjust the width of this particular column. Similarly, you can add conditional formatting to the percentage budget consumed column as well. I'm going to select this particular column. Conditional formatting, data bars, and let's say a solid fill, this time the yellow color. You can click over here again, manage rules, and edit the rule, number 0 to 1. Okay and okay. So part of my dashboard is ready. Now the next thing that I want to add is the slicers. In order to add the slicers, let's add a few rows at the top of this dashboard. So in order to add the slicers, first I'll click anywhere inside the pivot table. In the ribbon, you'll see the pivot table options available. Click on Design, click on Pivot Table Analyze, and here you can see Insert Slicer. Click on it and select the slicer that you want. Like here, you want the project name. Press OK. So this is how your slicer looks like. Now you would want to align this particular slicer in a single row. So what you need to do is that you need to increase the number of columns to 5. The slicer edit menu is open in the ribbon. I'll go over here in columns and enter 5. Now we can adjust the slicer like this. And let's say put it somewhere here. Now I can add the second slicer as well. Click somewhere here, press Pivot Table Analyze, and then Insert Slicer. The second one is Task, and press OK. So I've got 10 tasks and I would want them in 2 rows. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to add 5 columns over here, and then I can adjust the slicer width like this. Let me add a third slicer for the manager. Go to Pivot Table Analyze, Insert Slicer, and Assign To. Press OK. Again, I know that I've got 5 people in my team. So the number of columns I'm going to select as 5, and then adjust the width of this particular slicer like this. I can also change the colors of the slicers. As soon as you select a slicer, its menu opens up in the ribbon. And from here, you can select the desired color like this. And now let's see how these slicers work. Let's say from the slicer assigned to, I select Angela. You can see only the tasks that have been assigned to Angela. You can clear the filter by clicking here and select someone else. Similarly, you can do that for tasks as well and the projects. You can do that for a combination of 2 slices. Let's say it's Angela and project 1. And let's say Ben and project 5. So friends, you saw how easy it is to make such a dashboard using pivot table and slices. Now let's try and create the reports for every team member and then the project reports. Now let me open a new tab to create the people dashboard. Now the first thing is that we need to decide what are the various statuses that we want to show in this particular dashboard. Let's say I want to show task status, then I want to show the day's status and the budget status. In the task status, I want to showcase not started, in progress, and completed. In the day status, I want allocated and completed. And in budget status, I want allocated versus spent. Now these three reports, you would want to add them team member wise. So let's just add a filter over here to select the team member. You can go to the task list and copy the names of your team members like this. I'll just paste them somewhere here. In this cell, I'll add select team member. And in the next cell, I'll add a data validation and select these five team members. From the ribbon, go to data, data validation, list, click on the source section, select these five team members and press OK. I get a drop down over here and I can select my team member. Let's say at the outset, I select one team member to create the reports. Let's add some formatting over here to these reports. I'll just merge these two cells. I'll add some borders over here. Similarly, I'll do it to the other two reports as well. Now let's add the function for not started tasks. Now for not started, we know that we have got two things to check. One, that the team member is Tom, and the second one, that the progress is not started. So here we will use a count ifs function. So what we're going to do is that we're going to do equal to count ifs. Now criteria range one, that's going to be the team member. So I'll go to the task list, select column C, which is assigned to, comma, come back to sheet 3 and select the team member here, comma, criteria range 2 is going to be the progress, which is column L, the task status, comma, and criteria is going to be not started, which is this particular cell. Enter. So this function is going to give me not started tasks for Tom. Now we want to replicate this particular function to the other statuses as well. In order to do that, let's first of all fix the cell references. So criteria range 1, which is the name of the team member, is going to be constant, so let's fix it. The criteria 1 is the name of the team member, again it's going to be constant, so let's fix it again. The criteria range 2 is the task status, so that is going to be constant as well. And criteria 2 is the actual task status. Now here you can see that with every status, the row number is changing, but the column number is going to be constant. So C is going to be fixed and the row number will vary. Now this function is ready and we can just replicate it to the other cells. Copy the cell and paste it in the other two cells. If you want to do a cross check, go to the dashboard and select Tom from the slicer. Let's go over here, select Tom. So here we are seeing that there's one task which is not started. So there should be one task with 0%, which is this one. Completed is 0. So there is no task which has got 100% value over here. And then there are another 7 tasks which are in progress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So function is correct. Similarly, we can put the status for days as well. Now for the allocated days, we need to sum all the days that have been allocated to this particular person, Tom. And then for completed, we need to sum all the completed days that have been reported by Tom. So in both of these cases, we will use a sumif function. Let's do it for the allocated one first. So our function will be equal to sumif the range. Now this range is where we will define that the team member is Tom. So it's going to be the names of the team members. We'll go to task list and select assigned to column, comma. The criteria is going to be the name of the team member. Go back to sheet 3 and select this cell from here, which has a team member name, comma. And then the corresponding sum range, it's going to be the number of days allocated. Go back to task list and select ETA days column over here. And bracket close and enter. This gives you the number of days that have been allocated to Tom. Similarly, we can see how many days have been reported. In order to do that, we'll do equal to sumif the range which has the names of the people, which is column C, comma. Go back to this sheet, select the cell which has the team member, comma, sum range, go back to the task list, and here we'll select the number of days reported. Bracket close and enter. Now we have the day status as well, which is allocated and number of days completed. And now the last one is the budget status. Here again, we'll use the sumif function. For allocated budget, it's going to be equal to sumif. The range is going to be the names of the people. So we go back to the task list and select the names, which is column C, comma. Criteria is going to be in the same sheet, this particular cell, comma. The sum range is going to be the allocated budgets. Go to task list and select this particular column, which has the allocated budget. Bracket close and enter. Similarly, for spend, it's going to be equal to SUMIF, the range which has the people, column C, comma, this particular cell where we are selecting the team member, comma, sum range in the task list, actual till date, bracket close and enter. Now you have data for task status, day status and budget status for a team member. We added a data validation over here so that you could change the team member, and let's see if it's working or not. So just click over here. Here you go. You can see that with every team member changing, the numbers are also changing accordingly. Now what you can do is that you can add graphs against each and every status. Let's say for task status, I want to add a pie chart. So I will select these three statuses like this. Go to Insert from the ribbon, Charts, and let me select a 3D pie. You can make some changes in the formatting to show data labels and remove the titles as they are not needed. Now I want to add a donut chart for day status. Select these two statuses along with the values, Insert, click on Charts and select the particular chart that you want, and then make the required changes in the formats. Similarly, you can add another graph for budget status, something like this. Once you edit the charts, you can then make changes to the format as you would want and make your dashboard look something like this. So here you have the manager name or the team member name. You can change the name of the team member or manager from here to look at the numbers. The same way you created the people report, you can also create the project dashboard. Here again, I have got the task status, days completed, and budget versus actual. Instead of people, we have got the five projects over here, and using COUNTIF and SUMIF functions, we have got the values for each and every respective projects. After that, we have created project-wise graphs for days report, task report, and budget report. You can see all of these reports from project 1 to project 5. I also added a link in the description from where you can download this dashboard. So friends, you saw how we transformed a task list like this into a dashboard which looks something like this and has got slices for selecting projects, for selecting tasks, and for selecting people. Plus we got a separate people's report where we can select a person and look at their reports. And then we also got a project-wise dashboard. If you really enjoyed watching this video, make sure to hit the like button and share it with your friends. And friends, that is the end of the video. Until next time, bye-bye.